Data science is one of the most in-demand careers currently, as increased quantities of data are created in the world. Companies want to use insights from data to better connect with their customers and solve real-life complex problems. To be successful in gaining insights, data scientists need to master the full spectrum of skills, right from machine learning, natural language processing, artificial intelligence, deep learning, and much more. Data exists in multiple forms, like conversations and tweets. This is an example of unstructured data, which doesn't fit into databases neatly. It does, however, represent the bulk of the data available in the world. Natural language processing trains machines to process data derived from natural human languages. It lies at the intersection of data science and human language and is increasingly used by the industry. In this video, we will be introducing the subject, what is NLP, in the context of machine learning. In this natural language processing tutorial, we will briefly discuss the applications of natural language processing and how to tackle NLP projects successfully.
Hi guys, this is Rohit, and today we are going to talk about natural language processing. Natural language processing is basically nothing but the normal language that we converse in, right? So the way we are talking and the normally way we write, how we can process all of that. So that's exactly what is natural language processing. And today we are going to kind of cover a lot of detail about natural language processing. So let's get started with it. Yeah, but before we kind of get started, there's a small kind of introduction talk about it, which is basically NLP and for that matter time series as well, right? So both of these are very correlated topics, and these are nothing new, right? This both of these topics are nothing which is extremely different from your machine learning, rest of the machine learning course. The only thing that is different from NLP and time series is basically the feature engineering part, right? In NumPy, if you just have a free flowing text, right, which is basically any text that you have, you cannot just directly put that in a NumPy array, right, because NumPy would not accept a string variable. So there's an introductory talk that is kind of relevant before we kind of get started with the entire thing about NLP. So NLP and time series are basically nothing but sort of domain specific understanding of machine learning problems. Given all kinds of these are basically at the end of the day the same kind of supervised machine learning things that you have already dealt with in your rest of your machine learning course. All that we are going to do right now is basically try and understand sort of feature engineering kind of things that were very specific to these domains, right? So for NLP as well as time series, the only thing that we are going to do is basically understand feature engineering, the way we kind of do feature engineering specific to each of these domains. And once you understand that, that's pretty much about it, right? Rest of the stuff, right? Rest of the when you get an X train, so that would basically convert your given data into the X, Y columns, right? So you would have feature columns and you would have your target variable. And once you have that, right? So rest of the things that you do with it are absolutely, absolutely the same that is there with rest of the machine learning curriculum, right? So that's the outside. So don't get kind of very, confused, I would say. Don't get scared by what is NLP and NLP. Obviously, NLP is a big topic. There's a non-machine learning part of it. There's a machine learning part of it. We are going to mostly focus on the machine learning part of NLP. But because we are focusing there, so just the thing to keep in mind is, trust me, this is extremely easy. This is just kind of a follow-up and domain-specific understanding of the things that you have already done in your machine learning part, right? So that's about it. So now let's just get started with it. Program so far, obviously you have done Python, you have done statistics, you have done the supervised machine learning thing and unsupervised machine learning thing. And today what we are going to talk about is basically something which is just an extension of your supervised machine learning part. The only difference being what we are going to do is basically learn how to do feature engineering for this particular task, right? That's about it. Nothing more, nothing less. So agenda for NLP, this is the agenda for the day. So there are a lot of basically the first part of things. So I kind of give you an agenda how it looks like. So there's a first part of things, first probably 1, 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, right? So all of these are basically, a good part of these are basically kind of cleansing, data wrangling part of NLP. And then there's something called a feature extraction part of NLP. So we are going to understand both of them today. That's the idea. So there's something which kind of goes into, so when you collect the text data, right, that is extremely raw, right? So if you're scraping websites, or if you're collecting data from blogs or something, somewhere you're kind of collecting data from a lot of places, the data is normally and almost always not clean, right? So there's a part of sequences that we are going to learn how to clean that text data, because text data normally comes in all kind of spelling errors, grammatical errors, you know, all words which are very similar have been included. So there's a lot of processes and understanding of those processes around cleaning the data. That's what we're going to focus first part of the lecture on. Then the second part is, once you have the clean data, how to kind of convert that into a numerical feature, right? So just to kind of make sure we understand the point. So so this is a text, right? So this is a text data. So all we are going to concern about is that, so basically we are saying, let's say we are trying to do some NLP task where we say we are trying to detect the sentiment of it, right? So let's say so this is a statement that we have, and say we are trying to detect the positive, if there's a positive sentiment or a negative sentiment. So this is 0 for negative and 1 for positive, right? So we are trying to detect which is the kind of sentiment that this particular thing carries, right? So we have a lot of text like this, and for each text we basically have it labeled as 0 and 1, and for given any text like this particular text, we are trying to figure out whether the sentiment associated with this text is positive or negative. Fair enough. Now obviously when we have a data like this, so the data looks like this, right? So you have got one text, and then you have got text 2, and then you have got text 3, and for each of these corresponding pieces of text you have a sentiment associated with it, right? 1, 0, 1, 0, and so on and so forth, right? So that is the whole goal of, so what we are trying to do is basically, obviously we cannot feed a text like this into NumPy array, right? Because there's a string, and string NumPy only takes numeric characters. So all we are concerned about is how we can represent this into a sort of features such that, which are representative features, right? So feature 1, feature 2, so on and so forth. Say I don't know, probably some 100 features, right? So all we are concerned about is kind of taking this text data and representing it in sort of a feature, right? So that's the goal of the day today, to do this part of the task. And so for doing that part, so there are two parts to it, obviously, as I've explained. One is kind of, you know, there's a lot of exclamation mark, there are full stops, there are capitals. So one part of the job that we're going to try and do in the first place is kind of clean this text up. You know, just make this all smooth and awesome. Once we do that, then the next part of the task is how, with that clean data, how we can convert into a feature vector which looks like this, right? So for each text we'll basically have a sort of 100 features that kind of represent this text, right? So that's the goal of the day today, to kind of do that, and that's what our agenda looks like right now. So two parts to it. So one part is kind of cleansing, data wrangling kind of part. The second part is more of vectorizing that text into a sort of vectorizer. So what is NLP anyway? So this is something that we are already sort of familiar with. So the natural language that we write and read in, right? So that's the language that we are normally conversing in. So any kind of processing technique, any kind of algorithmic technique that we use on understanding and making sense out of that particular kind of language based data is what is natural language processing, right? Nothing much in it. So as you can see, right, human language is obviously ambiguous. It's changing and evolving and every time. So, you know, you look at the kind of language that we talk in, right, and language that we write in. So that is also changing, right? So probably 50 years back, what kind of language, the same sort of language, I'd say English, the kind of way you write it 50 years back and the way you are writing right now. So, you know, the spellings get changed, the meaning of words get changed and all of that is always evolving. So that's why there's a huge, you know, there's always ongoing research on NLP because the way we are writing is keeping on changing. And also there's the fact that there are a lot of languages. So currently for this particular lecture, we are going to be talking mostly about English. But a lot of interesting work is basically kind of happening in more of native languages, like especially in India, in in Hindi, Bengali, Punjabi, Odisha, and all of those languages are there, right? So a lot of interesting work is happening there. So if you're up for it, if you kind of grasp all of this very quickly and kind of go to the depth of NLP as such, there's a lot of interesting work happening on Devanagari script based languages. So that's mostly about NLP. So now let's kind of try and understand. So NLP as such is the task of kind of making sense out of that data. Now, how many ways can you make sense, right? That's the task. That's the understanding that we are now trying to build, is what are the things that you can kind of do with NLP? So obviously some of the things that you can see are spam detection, chatbots, recommender systems. So basically any part of thing where you're kind of taking a natural language and kind of making some inference about that language, right? So that those are basically the tasks. So spam detection is basically where you look at a text of mail. So you have your incoming mail, and from that mail you are trying to kind of infer whether that mail is a spam or not, right? So very easy supervised machine learning problem actually. Chatbots is the same kind of thing. So where you are where the user is basically kind of giving his replies in natural language, you are kind of trying to understand that. And then based on that understanding, you're kind of, so first part is kind of encoding that into something. And then based on what the user has asked, you kind of search for that particular thing in your database and give him back the query that he has asked for. So again, NLP kind of, NLP is almost probably everywhere you can see, right? So in fact, for sentiment analysis, where you're trying to look at, say, Twitter data, right? And Twitter data, say, you're trying to predict what is the current sentiment of a particular company. And then you're trying to look at it, and then you're trying to see that whether if the company is performing well or not. And then you're trying to look at the tweets about that particular company and trying to see if there's a positive sentiment or a negative sentiment. 1-0. Right? So you're having a natural language based data, which is basically all the tweets themselves. And then you're trying to classify them into 0-1. So all this and a lot more of tasks are basically, all of these are examples of NLP, because NLP is frankly, any part of things where you're kind of trying to infer data from a natural language based kind of a data source is basically an NLP task, right? So you could have data sources which basically say, for example, you're trying to predict stock prices, right? So that is a classic example of a time series data, right? Time series kind of a thing. But then also in there, you would have something like you might want to do sentiment analysis. So basically you will collect all the data about that particular company, or tweets or news related articles about that particular company, and try and do kind of some analysis based on that. So when you're trying to analyze anything that is based on a free text, you are doing NLP. That's about it. So NLP is something that is fairly common, fairly in real life cases, at least a lot of use cases use NLP.
We hope you enjoyed our video, What is NLP? Find links to complete machine learning tutorial in the description box below. For more videos, subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon to receive notifications about new videos. Visit our website www.greyatom.com for further details about our programs in data science. Thank you and happy learning.